Not too long ago, we released a video covering the K20A and the K20C and comparing them to see which one is better. And overwhelmingly, you guys really liked that video, but something I noticed in the comments is that a lot of you guys wanted to know more about the different K20C variants that are currently available. In that past video, we only talked about the K20C1, but there are other variants of the K20C. Now, the two turbocharged variants of the K20C that we get in the US are the K20C1 and the K20C4. Today, we're going to compare them, find out the differences, and which one is better. Stay tuned. What's particularly interesting about comparing these two engines is that these are the only two turbocharged K20 engines that we've gotten thus far in the US. Honda also offers a K20C3 in China, but that's not something we're going to talk about in this video. Realistically, there are two different versions of the K20C4, one for the Acura RDX and one for the Honda Accord, but we're not going to get into the differences of those because those are like 99.5% of the same engine. So for the rest of the video, we're going to refer to the K20C4 from the Honda Accord. In case you didn't know, there are only three different vehicles that have used these turbocharged K20C engines so far in the US. The ones we're talking about today are the K20C1, which you'll find in the FK8 Civic Type R, and the K20C4, which is in the Honda Accord Sport and EXL. Now, what's interesting is that previous Honda Accord Sports got a V6 engine, but Honda decided to ditch that entirely in favor of the K20C4 because it's overall a better engine, makes more power and more torque. Now, before we get too deep into the differences of these two engines, we should briefly cover some basic information for those who don't know anything about these engines. Both of these engines are 2-liter turbocharged inline fours with an aluminum block, aluminum head, dual overhead cams, Honda's VTEC system, direct injection, a 9.8:1 compression ratio, and both engines are known for being incredibly strong. It should be noted that neither of these engines use VTEC the way that Honda used to use VTEC on their older K20A engines. What I mean by this is that older K20A engines have VTEC on both the intake and the exhaust cam with VTC on the intake cam. This is totally different from the K20C1 and C4, which only have VTEC on the exhaust cam, but they have VTC on both the intake and exhaust cam. What's cool is that the dual VTC system allows for valve overlap to be adjusted at any RPM or any load, which basically makes the engine way more efficient and allows it to make a little bit more power. Now, the reason for only having VTEC on the exhaust side on the K20C1 and C4 is that since both of these engines are turbocharged, they can basically just force air into the cylinders regardless of how big the valve lift is. Now, obviously, a tiny valve lift is going to be a problem, but the very small amount of valve lift that you gain from having VTEC on the intake side would make virtually no difference at all on a turbocharged engine. Power output for the C1 is 306 horsepower and 295 pound-feet, and power output for the C4 is 252 horsepower and 273 pound-feet. If you're looking at the aforementioned Acura RDX, C4 power output is slightly higher at 272 horsepower and 280 pound-feet. Starting from the top down, we'll look at the differences in the cylinder head first. Both engines use nearly identical castings, and both of them use the cast-in exhaust manifold that so many people seem to hate. One of the most obvious differences between the heads is the different base plates for the high pressure fuel pump and the C1's addition of a vacuum pump. The addition of a vacuum pump on the K20C1 is likely to reduce blow by, since the K20C1 uses higher boost pressure than the K20C4 and it also has a higher red line. Now, it could also be the case that Honda added the vacuum pump to improve emissions, or they could have even just added the vacuum pump to help with things like the brake booster. Since when you're in boost, your brake booster is not going to work the same as when you're in vacuum. Another very important difference in the cylinder heads is the fact that these two engines use different camshafts. Now, this is likely because the K20C1 revs higher and it basically needs more peak power, so it's going to run a more aggressive camshaft, where the K20C4 is more of a street engine, so it needs more low-end torque and mid-range power. And both of these engines also use different sized turbochargers, so the camshafts are sized appropriately to help the turbocharger spool up and be as effective as possible. The intake valves on the C1 and C4 have different part numbers, however, I was unable to find any information on how they're actually different, and the exhaust valves on the C1 and the C4 are both sodium filled. The sodium helps keep the entire valve cool, which basically lets both of these engines run a little bit leaner without making the exhaust valves too hot. The intake manifolds are nearly identical as far as I can tell, and the throttle bodies are the exact same on both engines. As far as direct injection go, both of these vehicles use totally different systems. The C1 has a system that's designed for basically a ton of flow and the ability to support a lot of power, where the C4 has a system designed around best of fuel efficiency possible and delivering good mid-range power. To put it simply, the high pressure fuel pump, the fuel rails, the direct injectors, pretty much everything in the fuel system between these two engines is different. Arguably, the most important difference between these two engines are the different turbochargers. Since the K20C1 is designed for use in high performance applications, it has a larger turbocharger, which is capable of producing more peak power. On the C1, you're going to find an MHI TD04 turbocharger, and on the C4, you're going to find an IHI RHF5 turbocharger. Now, the smaller turbocharger on the C4 helps it make more low-end power and more mid-range power, which is great for the street because you're not going to be revving your engine out to redline from stoplight to stoplight. You want a lot of low-end power and a lot of mid-range power so you can basically just get on the gas without revving the hell out of your engine. Unfortunately, that smaller turbocharger does become a limiting factor when it comes to tuning. You can push a small turbocharger like the one found on the K20C4 and basically increase its total RPM, but what you end up with is higher boost pressure at high RPM, but the problem is that air is going to be superheated because the turbo is so small, which is basically going to negate all the effects of increased boost pressure and also greatly reduce the life of your turbocharger. This is a problem that you'll see on a lot of Ford EcoBoost engines and even on the L15 from Honda. Of course, since each engine is in a totally different application and they're packaged differently, you're going to find different intercooler piping and intake piping. However, it should be noted that the intercooler cores are nearly the exact same size on both engines. Looking at the bottom end, both of these engines are very strong and they're well known for holding up to increased boost pressure and making a ton of power. Starting with the connecting rods, both of these use forged steel connecting rods according to Honda's press releases, and as far as I can tell, they're the exact same part number. There are reports of the connecting rods being different between both engines, but considering they use the same part number and they're pretty much identical in parts illustrations, I'm pretty sure they're the exact same part. Now, the pistons are definitely different, with the C4 using a pretty common flat top design with valve relief cuts. The C1 pistons use a more complex D-cup dish, which is likely done to help reduce detonation since the C1 runs more boost. Both of these engines have piston oil squirters, which are basically further down in the cylinder or at the bottom of the block, and they just spray oil up at the bottom of the piston dome, which helps keep the piston cool, which is really important for running high boost pressure for extended periods of time. Now, the crankshafts appear to be different, with Honda referring to the C1's crankshaft as ultra lightweight forged steel and the C4's crankshaft as super lightweight high rigidity steel crankshaft. But upon closer inspection, you'll find that both of these engines have the exact same part number for the crank, and they in fact use the exact same crankshaft. As to why Honda refers to them differently in their press release, I have no idea. Now, as far as the blocks go, they are nearly identical. The castings are nearly identical, but they do have different part numbers because the location of the crank position sensor is a little bit different on each engine. Now, to summarize all this information, it's basically easiest just to remember that the C1 has a lot of small modifications compared to the C4 that help it make more power and be more reliable while making more power. Most notable differences are the fuel system, camshafts, turbocharger, and the tuning. To put it simply, the K20C1 is just stronger and more capable of making more power than the K20C4. That doesn't mean that the K20C4 is a bad engine, it just means that it's not designed for peak power like the K20C1 is. I would not call these the exact same engines, as a lot of people have done and a lot of automotive publications have done. I would say that they're extremely similar, they're based on the same engine, and they're probably about 90 or 95% the same, but they are not the exact same engine. There are differences and they are significant and they make each engine unique for its specific application. Now, if you guys think there's anything I missed or if there's anything you want to add, please let me know down in the comments below. I'm not perfect and sometimes there is something important that I will miss while I'm researching these engines. So if there's anything I missed at all, let me know down in the comments below. That way we all know and we're all receiving the best information possible. While you're down there, be sure to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on future videos, and I'll see you guys in the next one.